Mario Guerrero. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Mario Guerrero. Dennis González.
Hello, how are you,
Yolanda
teacher?
Cativo. Hi, welcome.
Hello.
Welcome. Hello, hello, everybody. How are you? How is
Fine,
everything?
teacher.
How do you feel today? ¿Cómo se sienten hoy? I feel good, ta na 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 na, and I know that I would now, ta na 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 na, so good, so fine. I'm gonna make her my eye. Dum, 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 dum. ¿Qué tal la lluvia? ¿Qué está la lluvia?
Pues casi buenas noches a todos. Aquí en Santa Ana pues ha estado lloviendo casi todo el día y está bastante fresco el clima, rico para dormir.
Aquí se me fue la luz dos veces ahora en el día y una vez en la noche.
Where do you live, teacher?
Do you know where is La Evangelica University?
Yes.
So I live behind La Evangelica University.
Okay.
Yeah. Here it's hard. Así que si me quedo congelado, así como ayer, guys, yo pues ya puse datos en el phone, así que allí les voy a escribir para avisarles cualquier cosa. Ayer, casi terminando la clase, psh, se apagó. All right. Okay. All right, guys, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. ¿Quién me puede decir que se acuerdan de lo que vimos ayer? ¿Qué vocabulario se acuerda? ¿Qué frase? Palabra que se acuerda de ayer. Dígame. Dígame sin pena.
Hablábamos sobre el uso de a y am.
Ah, okay. ¿Para qué se usa el a y el an?
A cuando la pronunciación es en consonante y
Ajá.
el am cuando es en vocal.
Correcto. La pronunciación, no la letra.
Ajá, la pronunciación.
Very good, very good. Excelente. ¿Me puede dar un ejemplo?
Por ejemplo, a monkey
A monkey,
y house.
An house or an hour?
An hour.
An hour.
An hour.
A house y an hour. Okay. ¿Y cuando no se usa ni a ni an? ¿En qué situación no se usa ni el A ni el N? ¿Alguien que le quiera ayudar a mi compañero? Muchas gracias por su participación, George. ¿Alguien más que quiera ayudarle a George? ¿Que me quiera decir qué más aprendió
¿Cuándo
ayer?
es el plural?
Ah, very good. Cuando es el plural. ¿Me puede dar un ejemplo?
Yes. Monkeys.
Monkeys, ok. No decimos monkeys.
No.
Solo monkeys.
Monkeys.
Okay.
También estuvimos viendo el What's in your bag.
What's in your bag? Ese fue el fuerte de ayer. Eso fue lo más que estuvimos viendo. Okay, yo le voy a hacer la pregunta. What's in your bag?
I have a cell phone.
Very good. Okay, ahora hágasele a otro compañero.
Quiero ver a González.
Okay.
What's in your bag?
I have a case.
Very good. Hágale la pregunta a otro compañero.
Yolanda.
Yolanda.
What is your bag?
Glasses.
Okay, Yolanda, hágale la pregunta a otro compañero.
Astrid.
Astrid.
Uh-huh. What is in your bag, Astrid?
I have a cell phone.
Astrid, hágale la pregunta a otra persona.
A Carlos Mendoza. What's in your bag?
Carlos Mendoza. Carlos, Carlos.
Okay, okay.
Carlos okay, Mendoza. Oh, there he is. There he is. Uh-oh.
I have a camera.
I have a camera. Very good. I have a camera. Excellent. Okay, guys. Now, what I would like for us to do is we're going to move forward. And I would like for us to look at the platform. Repeat after me. By the end of this class.
By the end of this class.
You will learn.
You will learn
how to form. Yes, no.
Yes, no.
And where
questions
with B. All right. Let me have one volunteer. Carlos Mendoza.
Okay.
Volunteer.
Okay.
Go ahead. Read the question, Carlos.
Leo el cabezado o una pregunta en sí.
No, this one right here. By the end of this class, you will learn how to form yes,
okay.
No, and where questions with B.
Okay. By the hand of this class, you will learn how to form yes or no, and with question with B.
Very good. Applause for Carlos Mendoza. Now, Raul Burgos, léalo usted.
By the end of this class, will you learn how to form yes, no, and where question would be?
Excellent. Okay, solo dos observaciones para los dos. Repeat, okay. End.
Oh, okay.
You. Will. You will.
Where.
Very good. Okay.
What question would be? Okay.
Ahora vamos a ver el video. El video es pasado en tres partes. What? Where? When? How? And why? Okay. ¿Para qué se ocupan estas? What es para qué. What? Por ejemplo, yo te digo, ¿cuál es tu comida favorita? What is your favorite food? What is your favorite food? All right. Y tú dices, mi comida favorita es tacos. My favorite food is tacos. Me puedo comer 12 tacos. Oh, yeah. Where? ¿A dónde? Where? ¿A dónde está tu restaurante favorito de tacos? Where is your favorite taco restaurant? Mi taquería favorita sería Los Cebollines. My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines en la Gran Vía. When? ¿Cuándo vas a tu restaurante favorito? When do you go to your favorite restaurant? Los fines de semana. I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend. ¿Cómo te sientes cuando estás ahí? How do you feel when you are there? I feel so happy. I feel so happy. ¿Y por qué es tu restaurante favorito? Why is it your favorite restaurant? Porque los sábados tienen mariachis en vivo. It is my favorite restaurant because on Saturdays they have mariachis play live music. Boom. Okay. Everybody repeat. What is your favorite food?
What is your favorite food? What is your
favorite food?
My favorite food is tacos.
My favorite food is tacos.
Where is your favorite taco restaurant?
Where is
your favorite taco restaurant?
My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines.
My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines.
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
I go to
my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
How do you feel when you are there?
How do you feel when you are there?
I feel so happy.
I feel so happy.
Why is it your favorite restaurant?
Why is it your favorite restaurant?
It is my favorite restaurant because
it is my favorite restaurant because
on Saturdays they have mariachis play live music.
On Saturday, they have live music.
Music en vivo. Live music. Okay, I want you to copy the questions, copy the examples, copy the sentences, copy in your notebook. Copy. Are you finished?
No.
Papá, me tomo este café tuyo.
All right, let me have a volunteer, please. Let me have a volunteer, please. Can I have a volunteer? One volunteer. One volunteer. All right, I got two volunteers, George and Adriana. Como George ya participó, le vamos a dar chance a Adriana. Y de allí Adriana le va a hacer las preguntas a George. Adriana, quiero que le haga las preguntas a Mr. Santos.
Okay. What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is tacos.
Where is your favorite taco restaurant?
My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines.
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
How do you feel when you are there?
I feel so happy.
Why is it your favorite restaurant?
It is my favorite restaurant because on Saturdays they have mariachis play live music. Okay. Applause for Adriana. Good job, Adriana. Now, George le va a hacer la pregunta y Adriana va a responder.
Hey. What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is tacos.
What is your favorite tacos restaurant?
My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines.
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
How do you feel when you're there?
I feel so happy.
Why is it your favorite restaurant?
It is my favorite restaurant because on Saturdays they have mariachis play live music.
All right. George and Adriana, good work. Okay. ¿Alguien tiene una pregunta sobre esto? Sobre el vocabulario o lo que vamos a hacer. ¿Qué vamos a hacer?
Practice the conversation.
That's right. Very good, Yolanda. Practice the conversation in pairs. One student is going to ask the question and the other student is going to respond. Any questions? Any questions?
No.
Are you ready?
Yes.
All right. Lo van a practicar 3 minutos.
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
How do you feel when you are there?
I feel so happy.
Why is it your favorite restaurant?
It is favorite restaurant because on Saturday they have mariachis play live music.
Okay. You ask me.
Yes. What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is tacos.
Where is your favorite taco restaurant?
My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines.
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
How do you feel when you are there?
I feel so happy.
Why is it favorite restaurant?
It is my favorite restaurant because on Saturdays they have mariachis play live music.
Okay.
Okay.
They have
mariachis play live music. Mm-hmm. Okay. What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is tacos.
Where is your favorite taco restaurant?
My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines.
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
How do you feel when you are there?
I feel so happy.
Why is it your favorite restaurant?
It is my favorite restaurant because on Saturday they have mariachis play live music.
Good.
What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is tacos.
What is your favorite taco restaurant?
My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines.
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
How do you feel when you are there?
I feel so happy.
Why is it favorite restaurant?
It is my favorite restaurant because on Saturdays they have mariachis. Play live music.
Okay.
What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is tacos.
Where is your favorite taco restaurant?
My favorite taqueria is Los Cebollines.
When do you go to your favorite restaurant?
I go to my favorite restaurant on the weekend.
How do you feel when you are there?
I feel so happy.
Why is it your favorite restaurant?
Hi, Yolanda.
Hi, teacher. How are you?
Very good.
Okay. I feel so happy.
Yeah, because it's a nice day. It's
okay,
a beautiful
yes.
day. I sold one house today.
Ah, really? Congratulations, teacher.
Yeah.
But you work at the United States. Thank you, Jesus.
Huh?
Teacher, but you work with United States or what?
Yeah, my job is in the United States.
Okay.
Uh-huh. From El Salvador, but in the United States.
Okay. Like call center.
No. is not call center because I am not receiving people calling me. What I do is I investigate the court dockets in the courts in Florida. And I see what houses are in distress, right? The customer has the house, the bank in the neck.
Mm-hmm.
So I come and I offer the federal program to help them.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And every time I buy a house, boom, commission.
It's good.
Yeah,
money.
I don't work for a salary. I work by commissions.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Easy money.
I think it's not easy money.
For me, it's easy.
But you need to study a lot or not?
It's a lot of information. It's a lot of information. But Ruben Santos is a smart guy. It's not easy.
I'm so happy for you, teacher.
Look, I have...
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Look, these are my tools. Monroe County. Miami-Dade County. Palm Beach, Broward County. And this is my case folder. I don't have any cases because if they don't say, yeah, I don't waste my time. So these are my tools. I work right here. I go in these websites. It's 1, 2, it's 4 different websites for 4 different counties. Oh, the internet is so slow. Okay, for example, here, Brenda D. Foreman, clerk of the court, right? Ella es como un clergy. So, yo vengo acá y tengo acceso a todos los casos de todas las casas que se están repossessing. Right, yo aquí agarro el case number, lo pongo acá. Y me aparece el case. Boom, aquí está. Este es el docket. Esto se llama docket. Lo que nosotros aquí le llamamos el que lleva el récord de todo lo que está pasando con el caso. No sé cómo se dice en español. En inglés se dice docket. Y aquí estoy viendo todo el caso. Aquí está el caso. Boom, vengo yo y leo esto. Boom, boom, estudio esto. Veo quiénes son los abogados, qué hicieron, qué no han hecho, qué les falta, cómo les puedo ayudar, cómo le están haciendo trampa al cliente. Boom, y ya. Hago el estudio del caso. Después... Boom, le llamo al cliente. Oh, tengo abogado. Ah, ¿y tu abogado te ha dicho lo que está pasando con tu caso? No sé. ¿Quieres saber lo que está pasando con tu caso? Sí, sí. Ah, ok, mira esto y lo otro y lo otro. Pero tu abogado no te va a ayudar. Con un abogado lo único que estás haciendo es tapando el sol con un dedo. Porque al fin del día siempre te van a quitar la casa. Right. El tiene más abogados del banco que tú. Basically. Right. It's a crazy world we live in. Y eso es lo que paso haciendo todo el día. Estudiando casos. Y cuando yo, mis instintos me dicen, aquí huele algo. ¡Pow! Easy money. All right, vamos a ver el video. Listen, please. Sí que está lento.
Where are my keys? Hi everyone. In this class you'll learn how to form yes, no.
Por favor, saque la libreta y el lapicero para que tome apuntes, porque después del video quiero que me hagan preguntas sobre el video.
No, and where questions would be. We'll start by listening to a quick audio program which illustrates how this topic is used.
Oh no, where are my car keys?
Relax, Kate. Are they in your purse?
No, they're not. They're gone.
I bet they're on the table in the restaurant.
Excuse me, are these your keys?
Yes, they are. Thank you.
See? No problem.
And is this your wallet?
No, it's not. Where is your wallet, Joe?
In my pocket. Wait a minute. That is my wallet.
Let's try to make sense of the chart that you see on the screen. In order to form yes or no questions, we're going to follow the next formula. Verb to be plus this, or in this case could be these, plus some kind of complement. So verb to be plus subject plus complement. In this case, we want to say that the subject is this or these. So let's try to make some examples. As you can see on the screen, the example, is this your wallet? We have the verb to be. In this case, happens to be is. And then we're going to use this. The complement in this case is your wallet. And then, of course, we put a question mark there. The other example that you see on the screen, are these your keys? We have a verb to be, these, your keys. And, of course, we put a question mark at the end. Let me give a couple of more examples. Is this your cell phone? Question mark at the end. Are these your things? In order to answer this type of questions, you're typically going to answer with yes, it is. No, it's not. If it's plural, for example, yes, they are. No, they're not. Now that we understand yes or no questions with be, let's explore WH questions with be. We're going to follow a similar rule for WH questions. Let me go ahead and put that on the screen. WH word plus verb to be plus subject plus complement. The rule is very simple and it's quite similar as making yes or no questions. The only difference is that now we are adding a WH word. So what are WH words? Let me explain. We use WH words to get information from others. For example, who, what, when, where, how, why, are some examples of WH words. Now let's put that rule into practice. If we look at the example on the chart, right, we can see the question towards the right hand side It says, where is your wallet? So if we follow that rule, we're going to put a WH word plus the verb to be plus some kind of complement, wallet. And of course, we put a question mark there. Where is your wallet? Where are my keys? How are you today? Why are you hungry? Where is the police station? To answer WH questions, you now need to give information. For example, for the question, where is your wallet? Notice that the answer is, it's in my pocket. And also, all those questions that you heard on the conversation a few minutes ago. Now, it's your turn to make as many examples as possible. Practice making yes or no questions and WH questions. You should answer those questions as well. The more you practice, the easier this topic will become for you.
Sorry, guys. So, now, ahora lo que quiero que vean es lo que vimos. What, where, when. What. ¿Quién me puede hacer una pregunta con what? ¿Con what? Una pregunta con what. What are you doing? Una con where.
Where are you from?
Where are you from? Who?
Who are you?
Who are you?
Who are you? Okay. Yeah, good, good. Ahora, vamos a poner cinco acá, así como en el ejemplo. Who is your mechanic? My mechanic is Michelin. What are you doing? I am learning English. Where do you get your haircut? I get my haircut at Baskin's. All right. Yo allí les di tres ejemplos. Ustedes me van a dar por lo menos cinco ejemplos. En parejas. Cada quien lo tiene que hacer en su platform. Ready? Go.
Igual ahorita yo tengo lenta. Lo voy a hacer en el cuaderno y luego
lo pongo. El título no lo pusimos.
WH.
¿Cómo?
Question, creo que era.
Question.
Sí, ahorita veo que ver. Ahí está. Thank you, teacher.
You got it.
Okay.
es el título. Okay. Sería
what, where,
Bueno, vamos a hacer la primera. What is
teacher, una pregunta. ¿Podemos practicar también con los ejemplos que se nos puso ahorita ahí? Para practicar y luego completamos nosotros en la plataforma. Solo tres.
Ay, yo estoy en what me he quedado.
What yo hice, what are you doing? Where, ¿dónde?
No, when.
Ah, when, es cuando.
Cuando. ¿Qué ejemplo puso?
Bueno, puse con what. What are you doing? What is your name? Con who is your teacher?
Yo sí lo puse. What is the teacher?
Finish.
Yes, about.
All right, that's good. All right, let me have two volunteers. Victor and Clelia. Action.
Yes, hello.
Hello. Clelia Magaña, hello. Okay, Clelia no está. Vamos con Adriana.
Sí, aquí estoy.
Okay, ahí está. All right, vamos con Clelia. Apareció Clelia y Victor. Victor, I want you to ask Clelia the questions, and I want Clelia to respond, and then Clelia will ask Victor, and Victor is going to respond. Action, like Jesse Jackson, ready for action. Let's get it on like Donkey Kong.
Did we have to use the ones on the screen? Because me and the other guy, we put our own.
That's okay.
Okay. Okay, so who is the new USA president? I want to know. I don't know, because I don't
Joe
have
Joe Biden. Joe Biden.
Okay. Really?
No. I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know. It's Joe Biden. Let me check. Give me a second. Give me one.
I believe it. Too.
No, USA elections. There we go. Let me see. Joe Biden, 264. Híjole. Damn. Le está dando una revolcada. Le faltan 6 puntos para ganar Biden. Donald Trump, 214. Le falta por Houston. Excuse me, con I'm sorry, Donald Trump. Salud, Donald Trump. So, tu presidente será Joe Biden, básicamente.
Chico asked me the second question.
All right, next question.
Do I ask or she ask?
Hey, you ask. Victor, okay. Ask, and then Clelia respond, and then Clelia ask, and then Victor respond.
What's going on?
What's going on? Se le cortó la voz, Victor. What's going on? What's going on es como cuando uno dice, ¿qué hay? ¿Qué hubo? What's up?
I'm fine.
That's good. Do you play soccer?
I don't know.
¿No te gusta el fútbol?
No.
Where do you work? Or what do you do?
I am a business executive.
Okay.
All right, Victor and Clelia. Applause. Okay, now Clelia, ask, and Victor, respond.
Yes. Where you go to the cinema?
I go to the cinema when I get free tickets from my work. When I get like coupons.
All right.
What is your house?
What is what?
What is your house?
¿A dónde está tu casa?
Where is my house? Is in San Vicente.
Clelia?
How is your house?
Clelia, repeat.
How is your house?
Oh, how is your house? Nice, good question.
My house is very cozy because it's very little and my family is big.
All right. A lot of love.
Yes.
That's good. Okay, that's good. Clelia and Victor. Good job. Now, okay, yo sé que todos quieren participar. Lo puedo ver en sus expresiones. Así que vamos a dejar dos más. Carlos Mendoza y Raúl Burgos. Carlos, ask the question. Burgos, respond.
Oh, la copié en la plataforma, teacher. Y ahorita las bajo. Oh, por ejemplo,
uh-huh.
When do you, how do you, sorry, me voy a la plataforma que ahí la dejé.
No, hombre, hágalo a capela, yo le voy a ayudar.
when do you favorite sport?
Ahí sería, what is your favorite sport?
What is your favorite sport?
Mm-hmm. Raúl, ¿no se le escucha, Raúl?
My favorite sport is football.
It's football.
Excellent. Now, Raúl asked the question. Carlos, respond.
Okay. What is your favorite car?
My favorite car is a Mustang.
Woo! Carlos asked the question. Raul respond.
Why are the colors and the bar and the flag?
Repeat, please.
Why?
What?
What are the what?
What?
What the colors and the flag, El Salvador?
What are the colors in the Salvadorian flag?
Okay.
What is the color in El Salvador? No. Repeat, please.
¿Cuáles son los colores de la bandera?
La bandera del Salvador.
Ah, okay. The color en bandera, no sé cómo se dice.
Flag. Los colores flag. Que anda puesto Victor. Flag.
Blue and black and white.
Blue and white.
Right.
That's right. Good question. Okay, Raul, ask the question.
Okay. Okay. Where is your sister?
Where is your sister? Sister, I don't know.
I don't know. Good response. Good response. I don't know.
I don't know, sister.
Ah, no.
I am brother.
No tiene hermana, dice.
No, I don't know, sister.
No, I don't know, sister. Brother. No, ahí sería, I don't have a sister.
I don't have sister, okay.
I don't have a sister.
I don't have a sister, okay.
Ajá. Y le va a decir, tengo un hermano. I have a brother.
I have a brother.
Oh, Raúl, he has a brother. Okay, all right. Bueno, estuvo bueno. Ahora vamos con... Applause for Carlos and Raúl. Good job. Ahora vamos con... Guys, como ayer les quedé cortos 6 minutos, se los voy a reponer ahora. ¿Está bien? ¿Está bien si le reponemos los 6 minutos que faltaron en la clase de ayer ahora?
Yes.
Yes. ¿Sí? Ok. Ahora vamos Yolanda y Adriana. Yolanda asked the question, Adriana respond.
Okay. Hi Adriana, what is your favorite color?
My favorite color is green.
Okay. How old are you?
I am 38.
Okay. What are you here? Why are you here?
I don't understand the question.
Why are you here is ¿por qué estás aquí?
Está aquí.
Esa pregunta tiene, es una pregunta un poco amplia, porque podemos decir, why are you here? Por ejemplo, puedes decir, estoy aquí porque Dios ha puesto un propósito en mi vida.
No. Por favor.
Estoy aquí en mi cuarto porque no puedo salir. Whatever. Usted respóndalo como usted piense.
I am here because I want to learn English.
Perfect, Adriana.
Very good response.
What is your birthday? Oh, when is your birthday?
Was September 8th.
Okay. And I don't know. Where are you going? Oh, where are you doing? Oh, no, ¿verdad, teacher? Where are you going?
Where are you going? Es para dónde vas.
Where are you going after the class?
To sleep, dígale.
Oh my God.
I am going to sleep, diga.
Okay, to bed.
I'm going to close my eyes.
I am going to close my windows
yes.
Because it's raining.
Okay.
All right. Good job, ladies, Yolanda and Adriana.
Okay.
Now, vice versa. Adriana asks the questions and Yolanda responds.
Okay. Why you study English?
I am studying English because I need to learn about this language. It's okay.
But it's a good question. I am studying English because I need to learn this language. That's a good question. But you can say, for example, I am studying English. Guys, give me one moment because it's raining really hard and my windows are open. Give me just one little second. All right, I'm back. Sorry about that. I had to, my dog has a blanket, so I had to cover him. He's cold. It's very cold, and it's raining a lot.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, now what I would like for us to do is move forward, and we're going to look at the next section. Here, on the following one, you are going to complete the conversations and select the answers for each sentence in the question. For example, number one, this your umbrella? No, it's not. ¿Qué vamos a poner aquí?
Is.
Is this your umbrella? Good. 2A. These your keys? Yes, they are. Thanks.
Are.
Are my glasses? They are on the table.
Where?
Is this my pen? No. It's mine.
It's not.
Ding, ding, ding. Correct. That is correct. Any questions?
No.
Now, on the next activity, we're going to be looking at prepositions of location. In front of, behind, on, next to, in under. So your homework is going to be to practice the prepositions of locations. And then you're going to give me 5 examples in the discussion forum. All right, guys. Thank you. You have a good night. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm. Bye-bye. Good night. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Good night. We got the lyrics in Perio College material. The same players that would go out the brain mineral. Do you want to ride in the backseat of my caddy on top of the do or die? Good night.
Okay, bye, teacher.
Bye, guys. Bye. Bye-bye. Take care.